Hello and welcome students. In the last video lecture, I had explained you exercise 3.2, question number 5, 6 and 7. Now, in this video lecture, I am going to start new topic of chapter number 3, linear regression, that is coefficient of determination. Now, what is coefficient of determination? First of all, let us understand this terminology. As you can see on the board I have written, it is the square of correlation coefficient. Correlation coefficient means the second chapter, that is R, correlation coefficient, between observed and estimated value of Y. You are knowing Y is a dependent variable and X is an independent variable. So the correlation coefficient, square of correlation coefficient between observed and estimated value of Y. Observed means whatever the value that has been given to you, actual value of Y, and the estimated value of Y. The square of correlation coefficient between observed value and estimated value of dependent variable Y is called coefficient. It is denoted by capital R square. Students, you are knowing we are denoting correlation coefficient by small r. Over here, coefficient of determination is denoted by capital R square. Now, capital R square is equal to R into bracket Y comma Y cap square that I have written. See, Y means the observed value of Y and Y cap means the estimated value of Y. So R into bracket Y, Y cap whole square. Now you are knowing the formula of Y cap, that is Y cap is equal to A plus BX. Now in A plus BX, A and B are constant. So after removing that constant, the remaining value that would be Y. So X and Y whole square. Okay, so X and Y whole square is equal to R square. Again, I'm explaining Y cap is equal to A plus BX. So from Y cap, A and B are constants. After removing these two constants, the only value that remains X. So you can see I've written over here X and over here the observed value of Y whole square. So from this Y and Y cap, it came to XY whole square. Now from that we can conclude that R square is equal to small r square. Capital R square is equal to small r square. Small r square means correlation coefficient square. Square of correlation coefficient. So in order to find coefficient of determination, we have to do square of correlation coefficient. Okay. Now, how to identify that the perfect linear correlation is there? What are the assumptions when you get the value of coefficient of determination? There are three options you can see on the board. The first one, that is capital R square, it means coefficient of determination. Whenever it is denoted by capital R square, it is the terminology for coefficient of determination. Okay, so capital R square is equal to 1. Now, if the value of coefficient of determination that comes to 1, then it is called perfect linear correlation. It means there is perfect correlation between two variables, that is X and Y. Now, if the value of R square that comes to near to 1, it means suppose it comes to 0.85, suppose it comes to 0.9293, or any value which is coming nearby to 1 but not exact 1, then it is called that assumption of linear regression is proper. It means it is reliable, it is proper. Linear regression assumption, whatever we are making, that is proper. Now the third one that you can see, that is capital R square, if it is near to 0, if it is near to 1, then it is called that it is proper. Assumption of linear regression is called proper. On the other hand, if the value of R square that comes near to 0, then assumption of linear regression is not proper or it is improper. So if it is coming nearby to 1, then it is called proper assumption. And if it is coming nearby to 0, then the assumption of linear regression is not proper. So after understanding the assumptions, or after understanding the conclusion of the value of coefficient of determination, let us take one of the example of the exercise 3, that is section F, question number 5, that is on page number 155 of your textbook. First of all, I'm reading question number 5 of section F, that is on page number 155. The information of 8 construction companies regarding the number of contracts received in a year and the annual profit is as follows. It means there are data given to you, that is of number of contracts that you can see I have written. Question number 5, X data, that is number of contracts. Total 8 data that have been given to you and annual profit that is given to you in lakh rupees, that is taken as Y over here. You can see that is 8 data of the annual profit that is given in lakh rupees that has been mentioned as Y over here. Now what has been asked to you? Obtain the regression line of the annual profit on the number of contracts. It means regression line of Y on X. First step we are finding B, then second step we are finding the value of A, and the third step that is Y on X, regression line Y on X. Now verify the reliability of the regression model. It may not be told in the question clearly to find the value of coefficient of determination, but the line is mentioned that obtain or verify or check. Obtain, verify or check the reliability of regression model. If it is told in the question to verify or check the reliability of regression model, it is understood that you have to find the value of coefficient of determination. Through the formula of coefficient of determination, you can check the reliability of regression model. So through this line, it is understood that you have to also find coefficient of determination. Whatever steps we were doing for finding B, A and regression line of Y on X, that is same as usual that we are doing in the previous sums while we are finding the regression coefficient. Over here the new step that is coming, that is to find coefficient of determination. When this coefficient of determination is to be found out, when it is given in the question that obtain or check or verify the reliability of regression model, at that time we have to find the value of coefficient of determination also. So let's start with the calculation or the practical solution of it. First of all, you can see the X and Y data that has been given to you. So first step of ours is what? To find the value of X bar and Y bar. From the value of X bar and Y bar, we can decide which formula has to be applied. You can see I have found out X bar and Y bar over here. You are knowing the formula of X bar and Y bar, that is sigma X upon N, and for Y bar that is sigma Y upon N. For sigma X upon N, sigma X total, you can see I have written over here, that is 56. 56 and total N number of observation, that is 8. So 56 divided by 8, so X bar that would come to 7. In the same way Y bar is equal to sigma Y upon N. Now what is the total of Y? Total of Y that comes to 4150. So 4150 divided by 8 is equal to 518.75. Now you can see one value of Y bar is coming in decimal and the other value that is not coming in decimal, it means it is coming in integers. So when any of the two values is also coming in decimal, then we have to apply the formula of XY, that is N sigma XY minus sigma X. And if you want to do the shortcut method, then we have to apply instead of XY, that is UV. So over here you can see I have applied the formula, that is UV formula, that is N sigma UV. You can also utilize the formula, that is N sigma XY. But over here you can see the data are comparatively bigger. So in order to make the data smaller, we have applied the formula of U and V. You can apply the formula of X and Y also. Okay, so I have applied over here because the data are comparatively bigger. To make that data smaller, the formula of U and V that I have applied over here. Now moving on, first column that we have to prepare, that is of U. So U is equal to X minus A. I'm not taking CX over here because all the values of X you can see that are below 10, that is nearby to 10 or 15. So we don't need to take the value of CX over here. You can easily do the calculation. Okay, so X minus A. A I have taken as 8 over here. You can take 7 also as it is. Okay, you can take any value because it is assumed mean. Okay, so I have taken 8 over here. You can take directly 7 also as it is the actual mean that has came of X also. Okay, now I have taken X minus A value that I have taken as 8. So subtracting each and every value of X from 8. So first one that is 2. So 2 minus 8 it would come to negative 6. 5 minus 8 that would come to negative 3. 9 minus 8 so plus 1. 12 minus 8 so 4. 6 minus 8 so minus 2, 4 minus 8 so minus 4, 8 minus 8 so 0, and 10 minus 8 that would come to plus 2. Now after getting the value of U, we'll be moving on to find the value of V. Now in case of V, where the formula you are knowing, that is Y minus B upon CY that I have taken over here. The reason, you can see all the data of Y that are in multiples of 50. It means last one digit is everywhere there is 0 and they are all divisible by 50. That's why I have taken CY as 50 in order to make the value of V smaller compared to the actual value of Y that has been given to you. Okay, and now actual mean of Y that is came to 518.75. Not to take in decimal, I have taken one of the value of Y, that is 700. You can, students, you can take any of the value. If you take 1000 over here, you can take 12 also over here. Any of the value of X and Y, you can take as A and B. But total would come different. Whatever the total I have got over here, that is of sigma U, sigma V, V square, U square, whatever the totals that I have got, you will get different totals. Ultimately, the answer would come the same. It means don't get panic if your totals are coming different, because you might have taken different values of A and B. Over here, I have taken the value of A, that is 8, and value of B, that is 700. So my total came like this way. If you are taking any other value of A and B, then your total of all these values that would be coming different. But ultimately, the final answer of B and A that would come same if your calculation is correct. Okay. Now V is equal to Y minus B, B value that I have taken 700, and CY that I have taken as 50. Over here I have taken CY purposely because all the values of Y you can see that are in multiples of 50. Now first value, that is Y value is 100. So 100 minus 700, that would come to minus 600. Minus 600 divided by 50, it would come to minus 12. Same way, 300. 300 minus 700, it would come to minus 400. Minus 400 divided by 50, it would come to minus 8. And so on, we have to find all the values of V. After getting the values of U and V, we have to find the next value, that is UV. UV means multiplication of U and V. So here you can see first value, 6 12s are 72, negative negative will become plus, 3 8s are 24, minus minus will become plus, 0 into 1 so 0, 4 6s are 24, 2 7s are 14, 4 9s are 36, 0 so as it is 0, 2 1s are 2. After getting the values of UV, the next step, that is to find U square. Now you can see I have found out V square also. The reason for finding V square is really not required in the formula of B. You can see in the formula of B, I do not require anywhere sigma V square. I only require sigma U square. But even though I have found out sigma V square for the reason of getting coefficient of determination. So one column extra we have to prepare over here when it is asked to you to verify the reliability of regression model. It means whenever we have to find out coefficient of determination, we have to find one more column, that is V square also. Now U square means multiplication of U twice. So 6 square that would come to 36, 3 square 9, 1 as it is, 4 square 16, 2 square 4, 4 square 16, 0 as it is 0, and 2 square that would come to 4. Now the last column, that is V square. As we have done U square, same way we have to do V square. So V square means 12 square, that would be 144, 8 square 64, 0 as it is, 6 6 are 36, 7 7 are 49, 9 square 81, 0 as it is, and 1 square, so 1. Now after getting all the values, we have to do the total of each and every column, because all that data will require in the concerned formulas. So first you can see the total of U, that is sigma U, that came to negative 8, sigma V that came to minus 29, UV that is 172. Students, while doing the total of U and V, don't forget the sign. If you don't consider the sign, then the total would be coming different. So how much total of negative and how much total of positive that comes, you identify and accordingly do the addition or subtraction. So be careful while doing the addition over here. So sigma U that comes to negative 8, sigma V that comes to minus 29, UV, that means sigma UV that comes to 172, sigma U square that is coming to 86, and sigma V square that is coming to 375. Now after getting all the values in the of the data, now we'll be moving on to the calculation part. First step that we have to find out, that is B. Okay, so B is equal to, we are going the formula, that is n sigma u v minus sigma u into sigma v upon n sigma u square minus sigma u whole square multiply by cy upon cx. Students, already we discussed that if in the question, in the table, you are taking the value of cy and cx, then in the formula of finding regression coefficient, that is in formula of B, you have to apply multiply by cy upon cx. If you forget multiplying by cy by cx, then your answer of B, that would be coming as wrong. So don't forget, when in the table you have taken the value of cy and cx, then don't forget to put the value of cy and cx in the formula of B. Okay. Now, first one, that is number of observation n, that is 8. Sigma uv total that you have got, that is 172. So 8 into 172 minus sigma u and sigma v. You can see sigma u value that I've got negative 8 and sigma v that is negative 29. So minus 8 into minus 29 upon n that is 8 sigma u square. You can see that is sigma u square total that is coming 86 over here. So 8 into 86 minus sigma u whole square, so minus 8 whole square. Now 8 into 172, if you multiply, you'll get 1376 minus 8 into 29, it would come to 232. But minus, because this minus sign would be as it is, minus plus would become, but outer side also there is minus, so minus 232. Okay, upon 8 into 86, it would come to 688 minus 8 square, so it would become plus 64, but this sign is minus, so minus 64 into cy value, what we have taken, that is 50. You can see in the table value of cy that we have taken 50, each and every value of y that we have divided by cy, that is 50. So cy that we have taken as 50 and cx we have taken nothing, so as it is I have written just 1 over here. Okay, now after getting all the values, the next step, that is multiplication that we have done, that is 1376 minus 232. Subtraction of these two values, that would come to 1144. 1144 multiply by 50 upon subtraction of this two value, it would come to 624. So multiplication of this two and divide by 624, the final answer of B, that would come to 91.67. Now after finding the value of B, next step you are doing, that is to find the value of A. What is the formula of A? A is equal to y bar minus B x bar. Already we have found out the value of y bar and x bar, that was our first step. Y bar value we have got find 18.75, x bar value that we have got 7. So as it is, we'll place in the formula. Y bar is equal to 518.75 minus B. So B value that we have got, that is 91.67 into bracket x bar. X bar that we have found out, that is 7 over here. So multiply by 7. So 91.67 into 7, it would come to 641.69. Now subtracting these two values, that is 518.75 minus 641.69. Subtraction of these two values, it would come to negative, because here it is smaller value compared to the negative value. So answer would come in negative minus 122.94. So we have got the value of A also. After getting the value of B and A, it has been asked in the question, obtain the regression line of y on x. So here you can see regression line of y and x, the formula is y cap is equal to a plus bx. Okay, so a value that we have found out, that is minus 122.94 plus b value that we have got, that is 91.67x, because no any value of x is given to you in order to find the estimated value of y. So this is your final answer for regression line of y on x. Okay, so first part of the question that we have completed. Now it has been asked to check the reliability of regression model. That is the new step. So students, pay attention this part. Whenever it is asked to check the reliability of regression model or to verify the reliability of regression model, we have to find the coefficient of determination. Now already I explained, you can see on the board that explanation part, what is coefficient of determination and what it is, what is its formula. capital R square. Always coefficient of determination is denoted by which letter? That is capital R square. Capital R square is equal to small r square. Now what is small r? Small r means correlation coefficient. It means square of correlation coefficient. Okay. So capital R square is equal to square of correlation coefficient. Now you are knowing the formula of correlation coefficient. That is n sigma u v minus sigma u into sigma v upon under root of n sigma u square minus sigma u whole square into under root of n sigma v square minus sigma v whole square. Now students, this formula you have already studied in the second chapter, that is linear correlation. Okay, so same formula we have to apply over here. Whole square, because r square, correlation coefficient, square of correlation coefficient. So whatever the formula we are writing, whole square we have to do over here. Okay. Now you can see your root is there and your square is there. So in order, your square will be removed and from your root will be removed. Okay. And over here you can see, first of all, value of n, that is 8, sigma uv, that is 172, minus sigma u value, that is negative 8, and sigma v, that is minus 29, upon 8, that is n value, that is 8, sigma u square, that is 86. You can see all the values we have found out, that is sigma u square value came to you 86. So as it is 86 minus sigma u whole square, that is negative 8 whole square, into 8, that is under root of n, that is 8, sigma v square. Students, I told you that we have to find out one more column in order to find the value of v square. That is v square we have to find out, that is 375, because we have to find out over here coefficient of determination. To find the coefficient of determination, we also require the value of sigma v square. That's why we have found the value of sigma v square, that came to 375. So 8 into 375 minus sigma v whole square, so minus 29 whole square. Now over here I have removed the root. The reason for removing root from the denominator is that over here there is root and over here there is square. So I will cut square from here and I will cut root from here. So over here square, in the numerator square would become, but in denominator the roots will be removed. Again repeating, in the numerator the square would be as it is, but in case of denominator the root will be removed and from here the square will be removed. So denominator, no any root or no any square would be there, but in numerator whatever the value would you will be getting, you have to do the square of that value. Okay. Now first of all, multiplication of these two values, 172 into 8, it would come to 1376, minus 8 into 29, minus minus plus, but outer side it's minus, so as it is minus. 29 into 8, that would come to 232 whole square. This numerator square, it would be as it is. In case of denominator, only square will be removed and root also will be removed. Now in denominator, 86 minus 64. So 8 into 86, that would come to 688. 688 minus 8 square, that would become plus 64, but outer side it's minus, so minus 64. 8 into 64 into 8 into 375, that would come to 3000. 3000 minus 29 square, that would come to 841, so minus 841. Now next step, that is the subtraction of these two values, 1376 minus 232, that would come to 1144 whole square. Don't forget to do square over here in numerator. In denominator that would not be square. Okay. Now upon 688 minus 64, it would come to 624. Into 3000 minus 841, it would come to 2159. Students, in each and every step, don't forget to do the subtraction and multiplication in a proper way. If you write a wrong digit, whatever you have written, and in case if you switch on to the wrong digit, then your calculation would come wrong. So while operating the calculator also, you have to verify the values. Okay. Now 688 minus 64, that came to 624, and 3000 minus 841, that came to 2159. Multiplying the denominator, 624 into 215, and in numerator 1144, it means 1144, you have to multiply twice. By multiplying it twice and dividing with the multiplication of this two, multiply 1144 into 1144 and dividing by 624 into 2159, you will get the final answer, that is 0.97. It means coefficient of determination that comes to 0.97. Now the value of 0.97, that is nearby to 1. Already I had explained the assumption, that are three assumptions I had already explained, that if r square value is coming to 1, over here you can see the r square value is coming near to 1. It is not coming exact 1. It is coming nearby to 1. So if it is coming nearby to 1, then the regression model is proper. So here you have to write the conclusion line. That is, hence the regression model is reliable or it is proper. Whatever you write is correct. Okay. So last concluding line you have to write on the basis of the answer that you have got of the coefficient of determination. So this was the new step, that is the coefficient of determination. This part, that is to find B and A, already you have studied in the previous sums that we had learned in the previous video lectures. So this was the new topic. So please revise again from the video lecture. Now, after understanding question number 5, in which we had studied to find coefficient of determination, let us move on the question number 7 of the same section, that is section F, last question of your exercise 2, that is on page number, same page, that is 155, that is a typical sum, different from whatever sums we have done till now. So let us read the question. The following results are obtained for a data. It means already the datas have been given to you, that is the value of n, sigma x, sigma y, sigma x square, sigma y square, that data has been given to you. But there has been a mistake done. See, later on it was known that one pair, that is 10, 14. 10, 14 means x value, that is 10, and y value, that is 14, was wrongly taken as 11, 4. It means the wrong value that has been taken, that is 11 and 4, instead of the correct value, that is 10 and 14. So whatever the values that has been given to you, that all are wrong values. So by placing the correct value of x and y, we have to again find all the values and then find the value of the b, a and the regression line of y or x. By correcting the above measures, it means now you have to rectify that mistake. Obtain the regression line of y on x and estimate y for x is equal to y. Also, you have to find the estimated value of y when the value of x that is given to you is 5. So, entire sum we have to do as usual only. Only the difference over here is that the wrong value have been placed of x and y. So, we have to place the correct value. Then afterwards, after placing the correct value, we have to find all the values again. Again, find the value of b. Then afterwards A, then afterwards regression line of y on x, and the last step, that is y cap, that is the estimated value of y. So first of all, let us start with the question, that is whatever the data has been given to me, the question that I have written over here, that is n value, that is 12, sigma x, that is 30, sigma y 5, sigma x squared, that is 670, and sigma x y, that is 344. Now the true value that is to be written, that is of x and y, that is to be taken, that is 10 and 14. And what is the wrong value, that is the false value, that is 11 and 4. It means whatever the data that has been given to you in the question, that is available after placing this wrong value. But we have to find the values of all this data by placing the correct value of x and y, that is 10 and 14. So again, we'll be finding the correct value of all the data. So sigma x, you can see first I've written corrected values. Okay. So now we're finding all the corrected values again. So sigma x is equal to, what is the wrong value that is given of sigma x? That is 30. So 30 plus the correct value, that is 10. So x correct value, whatever is the correct value, that we have to do plus. And whatever the wrong value is given, that we have to do as minus. So here you can see the correct value plus 10 I have done, and wrong value, that is 11. So I have done minus 11 over here. So 30 plus 10, that would come to 40, and 40 minus 11, that would come to 29. Now same way, that is sigma y. So sigma y is equal to 5. Sigma y value that is already given to you, that is 5. So 5 plus 14, what is the correct value of y? That is 14. So 14 and wrong value, that is to be subtracted, so minus 4. So the correct answer that would come to 15. Now next, that is sigma x square. Sigma x square is equal to 670. What is the correct value? That is 10. We have to do x square. So value of x, we have to do as square. The correct value of x, that is 10. So 10 square and wrong value, that is 11. So 11 square minus 11 square. So 10 square is equal to 100. And 100 minus 121. 11 square means minus 121. So 670 plus 100 minus 121 is equal to 649. Now sigma xy, sigma xy value that is given to you 344. So 344 plus that is x value, that is correct one, that is 10, and correct value of y, that is 14. So 10 into 14 minus wrong value, that is 11 and 4. So 11 into 4, that we have to subtract. So 10 into 14, that is to be added, and 11 into 4, that is to be subtracted. Whatever is correct. In short, whatever is correct value, that we have to add, and whatever the wrong value, that we have to subtract in order to find the correct value of the given data. Now 10 into 14, that would come to 140, and 11 into 4, that would come to 44. So 10 into 14, it would come to 140. So 344 plus 140 minus 44, it would come to 440. Then afterwards, x bar and y bar, that also wrong values were given to you. So we have to find the new values or the corrected values of x bar and y bar. X bar, the formula you are knowing, sigma x upon n. So sigma x, that is 30, that is given to you. But the corrected value of sigma x that we have found out, that is 29. So 29 upon 12. So 29 upon 12, number of observation, that is 12. So 29 divided by 12, it would come to 2.42. Now same way y bar. Y bar is equal to sigma y upon n. What is the correct value of sigma y that we got? That is 15. So now we'll take 15 divided by 12. Not 5 divided by 12. Because 5, that was the wrong value. What is the corrected value? That is 15. So now we have to find out the y bar, that is 15 divided by 12. It would come to 1.25. Now after getting all the values, we have to place it in the formula of B. N sigma xy minus sigma x into sigma y upon n sigma x square minus sigma x whole square. So n value that you already given, that is 12. 12 into bracket sigma xy. Sigma xy, now the corrected value will take, that is 440, not 344. Okay. So now the corrected value, that is 440 minus sigma x. What is the value, corrected value of sigma x? That is 29. What is the corrected value of sigma y? That is 15. So 29 into 15 upon 12, that is n sigma x square. What is the corrected value of sigma x square? That is 649. So 649 minus 29 whole square, that is sigma x whole square. Now you can see the calculation over here. 12 into 440, it would come to 5280 minus 29 into 15, it would come to 435. And in denominator, multiplication of 12 into 649, it would come to 7788 minus 29 into 29, 29 square, it would come to 841. Numerator, the subtraction of these two values, it would come to 4845, and subtraction of these two values in denominator, it would come to 6947. Now dividing these two values, the value of B, that would come to 0.70. Now after finding the value of B, our next step, that is to find the value of A. So here you can see formula of A, that is A is equal to Y bar minus B X bar. Y bar value, already we have found out the new value, that is 1.25. Sorry, by mistake I have written over here. 1.25. So 1.25 minus B value that we have got, that is 0.70. X bar value, new value of X bar that we have found out, that is 2.42. So multiply by 2.42. Now multiplying these two values, that is 0.70 into 2.42, you'll be getting 1.69. Subtracting it from 1.25. So 1.25 minus 1.69, so it will come in negative, so minus 0.44. After getting the value of B and A, next step is to find the regression line of Y on X. So here you can see I have written regression line Y on X. So Y cap is equal to A. What is the value of A? That is minus 0.44 plus B. What is the value of P? That is 0.70. X value has not been given. Now the last step, that we have to find the estimated value of Y when X is equal to 5. So we'll be putting the equation that is estimated. You are knowing Y cap means estimated value of Y. So Y cap is equal to A. What is the value of A? That is minus 0.44 plus BX. So what is value of b? That is 0.70. Now in place of x, what will you put over here? That is 5, because we have to find the value of estimated value of y when x value that is 5. So here I am multiplying with 5. So 0.7 into 5, it would come to 3.50. Adding with minus 0.44 plus 3.50, minus plus minus. So subtracting these two values, and you will get the answer, that is 3.06. So the estimated value, last concluding line that you will write, that the estimated value of y would come to 3.06 when the value of x is given to you, that is 5. So students, till now we have studied one topic, that is new topic, that is coefficient of determination. And one typical sum, that is the last sum of your exercise 2 of section F, that is question number 7. Revise these two sums again from the video lecture. In the next video lecture, still few more typical sums of exercise 2 will be doing. Till then, goodbye. Keep practicing. Stay blessed.